Frustration remained high in a Texas town tonight, 3 days after a police officer threw down an unarmed girl. The incident happened after a phone call complaining about a pool party, but gained national attention because of video showing the police response. William Brangham picks up the story.
Y'all keep standing here and run your mouth.
It's the video sending ripples of outrage across this Dallas suburb and the wider world. The footage shows a white policeman pushing down a black girl in a swimsuit and then pointing his gun at other black teens who seem to come to her aid. It happened Friday evening after a disturbance at a neighborhood pool party. Someone called the police and 12 officers showed up. Police Chief Greg Conley.
Upon arrival, officers were confronted by a large group of people. Private security and homeowners were pointing out juveniles who were creating the disturbance, fighting, and refusing to leave.
Conley says the youth did not live in the area and did not have permission to be there. Protest leaders say they did have permission.
On your face!
The policeman highlighted in the video, identified as Corporal Eric Casebolt, is now on administrative leave. Some in the neighborhood, like Sean Toon, say they support his actions. Toon even brought a sign to the pool on Sunday to make his point.
Watching 30 seconds or 7 minutes of a clip, it doesn't tell the whole story. I think he did what he thought he had to do to control the situation.
But one of the girls who organized the party says the use of force was over the top.
He was just aggressive for no reason at all. It was horrible.
Get on the ground.
Everything could have been solved entirely way better than what it was. I mean, there were other officers that were actually nice to people.
Today, community leaders and parents of some of the kids who attended the party called for Casebolt to be fired.
The fact of the matter, this officer recklessly attacked this young lady who was following his instruction to leave. That wasn't acceptable enough for him.
And McKinney's mayor, Brian Lawmiller, issued a statement saying he's, quote, disturbed and concerned by what the video shows. A protest rally is planned for this evening.
To discuss this in greater context, I'm joined now by Leona Allen, deputy managing editor of the Dallas Morning News, who has covered the area around McKinney. Leona Allen, thank you for joining us.
Thank you.
I wonder if you could start off by telling me just what is McKinney? What's the community like where all of this took place?
Sure. McKinney is a suburb north of Dallas. It has, you know, majority white, about 75%, and the population is about 10% black. But it's a suburb in Collin County, which is a high growth area for the Dallas area.
And has this community had a history of racial tension? I mean, it's not necessarily clear that the police officer's actions were driven by race, but is this something that you found surprising that it happened in this community?
I'm not totally surprised. You know, I've been in this business about 30 years now. Nothing surprises me anymore. But McKinney had in 2004 an incident in which there was a shooting where four people were killed, and the police actions were called into question then by the U.S. Department of Justice, the way they handled the case and handled the community afterwards. So it wasn't a total surprise. There has been some history of racial tensions there, but that was about 11 years ago.
That was not a police shooting someone, was it?
No. No, that was a shooting in an apartment complex on the east side, but how police handled the arrest and the community afterwards is what was being questioned by the Justice Department.
There were also some people who watched this video who said this to them was evidence that the police had done the right thing. And then you had people on the opposite saying the exact opposite. How do you explain that chasm?
Well, you know, we don't know what preceded this. We don't know what preceded the police arrival, but anyone watching that video, I think in general, folks agree that the actions of the one officer were over the top. Some of the police officers, if folks have seen that video, are seen de-escalating the situation. So there are people who support the police in that community and think that overall they did the right thing. The chief acted swiftly, which hasn't been the case in some of the other incidents around the country, which people supported and appreciated. Then, you know, it's hard to watch that video and not be disturbed, you know, as a mom, as a parent, as a community member, watching how the girl was treated.
As you say, you're a parent, I'm a parent of a young teenager. What is the conversation that parents are having now about how they would like their kids to interact when they confront the police?
Sure. I think that for most of us parents, we certainly are having conversations with our kids about being respectful. I think that was what the major concern was from folks who've seen the video, is that the officer was acting very disrespectful in his language and in his treatment of the crowd. I think several of the officers could be seen kind of trying to de-escalate it. And so, you know, you teach your children to be respectful of authority, and you hope that they do that, but you also hope the grown-ups are being grown well as they're treating kids. So it's a conversation we have often with our kids now, too often, because of these incidents happening around the country.
Leona Allen, the Dallas Morning News, thank you very much for talking with us.
Thank you.